Visit tapestryinsurancegroup.com.
If I traded it all, if I gave it all away.
So welcome back, everyone. Oh my God, we're having a lot of fun here at networking with everybody out there listening to us on the radio. My next guest has been on with me now several times. Listen up, everybody, because I only wish I had this service, that I knew I could have this service when I needed it. I have with me Carolyn Ray, and she's the owner of Professional Claims Management. Tell everybody, I know that we have a couple of people here that you have with you. One is on the phone. That's okay. We have that happening now, a lot more people. And we also have with somebody else. So tell everybody who's with you now today, too.
I have with me Michael, who is one of the adjusters in my office. He is working from home due to the coronavirus, and some people are at higher risk, as well as my admin is working from home because she cares for her elderly mom. And Antosh is with me in the office. He just came back on board with us. We're real excited to have him back. He's a genius. So is Michael. They both are. They're great.
Let me tell you guys what you do. First of all, you are there to help people have peace of mind when they have a situation that is going on that is really upsetting to them. So tell everybody what an adjuster is, and tell them what you do and how you work with people. Listen up, everyone.
Okay, I'll keep it short. Public adjusters are licensed by the state of Arizona as insurance adjusters, because the Department of Insurance realizes that everybody's entitled to representation. The insurance companies don't always take care of them like they're supposed to, and in my experience, they rarely do. They keep the nickels on the table, they cover the dimes, and it's all about their bottom line and not necessarily anymore about taking care of their insured. So we step in on their behalf, we represent them, we write estimates, we negotiate with the insurance company, we make sure that everything that they're entitled to under the policy that they get.
And you work on a contingency basis.
Yes.
That's another really good thing.
It really is. That means that we get a percentage of all the money that the insurance company pays out on your behalf. So the harder that we work for you, the more money that you make, the better off we are. So it's a win-win-win for everybody.
Sure.
There's no loss to the insured when working with us out of their pocket, because if they choose to work with our vendors will assist them with our fees. They'll make sure that everything's covered. We tend to get so much more money than they would ever get on their own that they can even go out and bid out their job and have it done by someone else.
Well, we're live on Facebook, so hi to everybody out there. Like us and follow us. We're going to be sharing this show. You forgot to mention that you also have Pearl with you.
Prometheus.
Yes.
Oh,
she also
floor.
Has, and it's okay. But if you see her, it's a him?
Him.
Him is, it's her dog, that her service dog that she has with her today. But look at how we're all making this all work. This is something else that I love, that you have people that you own a big company that you have where people can work from home. You're offering that to them. And I think it's lovely the way that we're all really trying to work together with everybody and make it all work. Now, I want to tell everybody my story real quickly, if you don't mind.
Please.
Because I know I have all your questions for today, but one of the things that I want to say is, people, listen up. Anything can happen to you where you have a situation where something happens, whether or not it's a pipe that bursts, you get a fire, your roof, you've got issues with your roof, and we're just having rain tomorrow, by the way. We're supposed to have some more rain. Any type of issue like that you're having, it doesn't have to be a complete disaster like mine. I lost my house in the Northridge earthquake, and I only wish I knew I could call a public adjuster when I didn't realize that anyone can do that. And I think that I want to get that out for people to understand it. Because what's the first thing we do? Oh, I'll just call my insurance company, right?
And we put all of our faith there.
Go ahead, tell them.
Oh, no, go.
I can talk so much,
I was hoping.
Well, so because you do call your insurance company, and I guess you have to. That's okay that you do, but you have to be very, very, very careful of what you say or what they say to you, because you know what? They sound like they're trying to help. Right, Michael? I want to try and bring you in, too. I mean, they sound like they're trying to help and everything like that, but they really are there for them. And here in this situation, when you know that you can call a public adjuster where they come out and they can assess that situation for you, and they're doing it on a contingency basis, and they're going to make sure that you really do get what you do. And explain to them why.
Why?
Why, the difference between calling just your insurance company, your regular insurance company, and you.
Michael, step in, please.
Yeah, I'll take that one. I mean, I worked for the insurance companies for more than a decade, and I can tell you from being on the agent side and on the adjuster side that the insurance companies are designed for profit. I mean, they do the minimum to provide what they say they're going to provide, and oftentimes they don't train their people. They don't allow the freedom for the qualified adjusters to review the policies in depth every time a call comes in and make sure that they're finding the coverage. And in fact, the system that they have is designed for speed, not efficiency, because if you ever look at the customer satisfaction ratings, it's always based upon how quickly your claim was handled. Well, speed isn't always the answer, because if you speed things up, you're going to miss over the important aspects of the coverage. And if they're not doing a proper investigation, if they're not properly reviewing the policy, if they're not asking the right questions, you're not going to get everything that you're entitled to. And you still pay the same premium to your insurance carrier, whether you're getting your claim paid in full or you're getting your claim paid in part. And you're still paying the same premium. You should get everything that they're charging you for.
You should. And here's the thing. They also work, they're based in Arizona, but you work nationwide.
Correct.
So anybody can call that's listening to us from all over. And you're both residential and commercial. Another thing I want people to know is that you do second opinions. I want to talk a little bit about that, because people don't realize that even if you've, I don't know what the statute of limitations is on that, but, you know, if you've had something happen to you and you were even, you think that you were covered, but you weren't, you don't know if you really got what you deserved, which I don't think anybody does, you can call them. Is that correct?
Right. We offer free consultations. We'll review your estimate, review the damages, see what, if anything, the insurance companies missed. And again, in my experience, they always miss something. We tend to get at least 40% more than anybody will ever get on their own. And after that review, if they want to hire us, we're more than happy to come on board and adjust the claim. And
well,
yes, here's my free.
Here's what we're going to do. We're going to give away a free, it's a survivor's guide to insurance. Let me tell you something. It's disaster preparedness. We need this. Everybody has to have this. Everyone should have one in their home, in their office, especially right now. Look what's going on. We're all stuck in our houses or in your businesses and you can't get out.
Yeah.
The number to call here for this is 602-277-5369. Toll free, it's 1-866-536-1100. It's just a guide of what you need, but not only of a guide of what you need to be prepared, but really when something happens, you've even got down exactly kind of how to do it, where to, the step by step. Tell them why you wrote it and what you did with it.
Exactly. It's a guide so that you can have some idea how to deal with your insurance company. Not everybody wants to have representation. So in there is a step by step things they should look for. For instance, getting multiple bids to make sure that the carrier has estimated their job properly. There's all types of tips and tricks and even tax ramifications I mentioned in there.
There is even also laws for you to know that they're your laws. They're to be protected for you. And what you need to do is call in here and get this. I believe, and I hate to say that, but I believe everyone should have the book. I have one in my office. Our number here is 602-277-5369. Toll free, it's 1-866-536-1100. You could check them out on their website. It's so easy to remember. It is onyourside.us. You can also call them direct. Their phone number is 480-840-1816. We don't know when there's going to be a disaster. And a disaster could be almost anything. Give them some ideas. Like, for instance, I said a pipe. What else?
A tree falling through your roof, hailstorm.
It happens all the time.
Fires.
Go ahead.
Yes, absolutely. And it's onyourside.us.com.
Oh, it is .us.com?
Uh-huh.
Oh, I'm sorry. Let me make sure I do that right. Onyourside.us.com.
Yes.
Go ahead. Okay, so before we go to a break, really quickly, I know you have with you, what is his name here?
Antosh.
Antosh. Antosh, you know, real quickly, what would be something that you would want to tell the people out there fast about what you're a public adjuster. Tell everybody really quickly what you would want them to know.
That you just need to document your claim. As soon as you have something happen to you, take the pictures, write down all the inventories of what's damaged, what's not damaged, and be ready to file that.
Well, I'll tell you what, we've got our lines up in here. We're going to go to a break, and when we come back, we're going to talk further. Everyone should have this book.
Thank you.
Hi. Hi, Solar Sandy here. Our number one priority is our families. In the current environment, we know how it feels to be in a situation where our safety is compromised and the future uncertain. Being a mom and a grandma and a retired nurse, I've given a lot of thought to how many of you are going to be affected directly or indirectly by the coronavirus. One thing is certain, we will all continue to have a power bill. Some people using even more electricity than others because children will be home from school and parents being impacted to having to stay home from work. So now I'm going to help 100 families with paying their power and their solar bills for the first 3 months. Remember, there's no money out of pocket to begin. This will eliminate your power bills in June, July, and August, and you will not have solar panel payments either for those months. It's just my way of being able to help families. Some of my solar families have already called to say thank you because they have a peace of mind knowing their family is being taken care of. God bless everyone. Don't panic, and let's just help one another. Go to AskSolarSandy.com and fill out your kilowatt worksheet today. Zoom conferencing is also available.
Newsflash, never be fat or smoke again. Break any habit or addiction in as few as 3 to 7 days. No withdrawal. Yes, you heard me right. No matter if you're 40 pounds or 140 pounds overweight, smoke one pack or four packs a day. You will be free. Call our information line at 623-266-1392 for free consultation. Your habit or addictive behaviors now can be a thing of the past. Call Hypnotic One at 623-266-1392. Now, you take control of your life instead of being controlled by life. Call now, Hypnotic One at 623-266-1392.
Do you suffer from low libido, midsection weight gain, irritability and impatience, or brain fog? You may be suffering from hormone deficiencies. At the Wellness Makeover Doctor at Mesa Naturopathic, our main goal is to discover the root of the cause and tailor a treatment plan unique to the individual. Trust your health and well-being to an Arizona-licensed family practitioner. We ask the right questions to help you. Contact us today at 480-306-8111 or visit us at mesanp.com.
Do you suffer from a mid-afternoon slump in energy? Do you lack focus? Do you want to feel better? Do you want that energy without the negative effects of caffeine? Most doctors recommend Mito 9. Hi, I'm Dr. Glenn, and I have the answer, Mito 9.
Hi, my name's Tim. I would suffer from lack of sleep, and it would affect my work performance. Mito 9 cleared my head in the morning. I was able to get rid of the brain fog and function at work the next day with no issues. I highly recommend Mito 9.
Go to Mito9.com today. That's Mito9.com.
After a house fire, what do you do? Where do you turn? Do you secure the property from potential theft and vandalism? Do you call your insurance carrier? Do you know what your policy will even do for you? Fire, water, and wind can have a devastating impact on your life. If you are involved in a property insurance claim, call Professional Claims Management to discuss your unique scenario. We want to hear your claim story. Call us at 480-840-1816 or visit us onyourside.us.com.
If you are an investor looking to defer and reduce your capital gains taxes while making your future growth tax-free, then Opportunity Zone Investment may be appropriate for you. Virtua Partners is a global private equity firm specializing in commercial real estate. We sponsor a variety of investment funds and commercial real estate projects across the U.S. For more information, please visit VirtuaPartners.com. That's V-I-R-T-U-A Partners.com.
So welcome back, everyone. We are talking with Carolyn Rain. She's the owner of Professional Claims Management, public adjusting. And it is so important that people hear this information, and that's what I love about the show. It gives people this information that you may not know about. So I wanted to kind of talk to you a little bit about what someone should expect when they file a claim. Just tell us a little bit about what that would look like.
Well, typically when we file a claim, we'll come out to the site and act as their representative and prepare our own estimates and basically be able to walk the insurance company adjusters through the building or through wherever the claim is and make sure that they're getting coverage for everything, because they usually go through with kind of a standard slate of items that they want to fix or improve. And we do a lot of claims with smoke damage and water damage where you can't see necessarily where the damage is, where that damage may come back. The smoke smell will come back in 6 months if you just repaint and clean over everything.
I think what's really important with what you said was because they're just looking for what they can, the least that they can have to do. And I know for sure firsthand, they come in and say, well, you don't really, you could get those shutters at like Home Depot when they were not. They were, you know, custom made. And so it hurts, it actually hurts a person, but people don't realize that they can actually call you direct and talk to you. You do a free consultation. You're nationwide. You do both residential and commercial and second opinions, guys. So if you've had something that has happened to you, and how long does the, did you say they have to wait? Is it too long for them to go? Is it 2 years or how many years is it?
Statute of limitations.
Uh-huh. It depends on the policy. Some policies have a 1 year or 2 year limit. Others, it really could be as long as you want. I think one of the areas where we're most helpful to people are where they file claims and their insurance company simply denies their claim. We can go back and reopen those claims for them and get them approved.
If you've been denied, give them a call. Their phone number is 480-840-1816. It's onyourside.us.com. Again, both residential and commercial. They do free consultation. Call in here and get this guide. I believe everyone should have it. I have mine. I gave my. You had a couple of them here, and I gave one to a couple of people that I knew.
Thank you.
It's Survivor's Guide to Insurance. It's disaster preparedness, but it's much more than that. It's basically what to do and knowing your rights as well. I want to also ask you about some of this other thing. So what does somebody do when a claims get then it got paid? What do they do?
What do we do to get claims paid?
Yeah, what do
yes.
you do?
Antosh.
Well, what we really do to get claims paid is we will go through your policies line by line and make sure where every piece of coverage is, because there's lots of coverages in there that for homeowners per se that people don't even know about. Coverage that may pay for the contents of your refrigerator that were spoiled when you lost power or when there was a fire, that pay to get your locks replaced on your doors when you lose your keys, that sort of thing. But there, you know, there's lots of coverages in there that the insurance company is not going to tell you about. They're not going to offer up the coverage. You have to ask them the right questions, and that's what we can do. Is because we have experience with this. We've worked with insurance companies. We know what the policies say. We make sure to ask all the questions to make sure you get what you were promised.
Well, they're on your side, and they work on a contingency basis. So the more that they get for you, the better it is for everybody at hand. Again, you can check them out on their website. It's onyourside.us.com. Second opinions, I think it's great. If you have been denied, give them a call. There's no reason why you shouldn't. 480-840-1816. They're nationwide, and they're also do free consultations. Real quickly, when we were talking a little bit about that, it's important that you can't read your own insurance forms and know exactly what everything says. You won't even understand it. And certainly, I think what you said was very important for people not to talk too much or talk to their insurance company themselves, correct?
Yep. File the claim. Make sure that the claim is filed. You notify them. But you're not required to go through an in-depth description or really you may not even know what to ask for as to what you need in terms of damages or what they can pay.
Michael, you're on the phone and you haven't even said anything. Chime in.
I know.
Tell us a little. I just wanted to make sure we included you on this.
Yeah, I've been waving my hand this whole time and haven't called on me.
But, I'm calling on you now.
Well, one of the things that I wanted to bring up as the reason for getting a public adjuster involved is because of our experience in understanding contract and understanding coverage. I'm working on a claim right now where there's an incredible endorsement that was left on the policy by the owner of the policy. It grants them unlimited increases in coverage as long as they met certain conditions. The insurance adjuster who is from the insurance company never said a word about this, never mentioned it, and the damages far exceeded what the policy limits were. But by uncovering this endorsement, we now have enough coverage to pay the entire claim, everything, including their contents, their additional living expenses, the entire demolition and reconstruction of the home. It brought their coverage up by more than 100%.
Amazing.
So and this is the stuff that as an adjuster for an insurance company, your responsibility is to represent the policy and the insurance company and provide the best interpretation for that coverage to your insured. But the unfortunate thing is the way the organizations are set up is that they don't allow the adjusters the proper time to investigate, evaluate, and review these coverages and make sure that they're doing the right thing. And I can't fault the individual adjusters. I fault the system. But unfortunately, those adjusters are part of the system, and they fall into those guidelines.
And unfortunately,
so we get involved to help out.
I also think that unfortunately, and we have to just say this, that they work for the insurance company that they work for, and they don't want to have to pay out as much money. They can as little as they can. Is that right?
Absolutely.
Yeah, I mean, a lot of insurance companies, they rate their employees based upon how much they pay out or how many claims they deny. Their full design is about minimizing what they call leakage, which is just an overpayment of claims. And really, it's not overpayment. Leakage is simply an expense that isn't accounted for in your business process. It's their own fault if they have leakage. What they should be paying for in the claims is 100% of what they owe.
If they have leakage, they need to call you, right? Isn't that funny? But I just had to do that.
Upon.
So let me just say, I know that was probably one of the things that you wanted to talk about, the story, but what other stories that you have that you might want to tell the people out there that have happened?
I mean, I think that there are so many stories, it's really hard to pick, but I mean, insurance companies will deny
come
claims.
Come closer, you got
to
come closer.
Insurance companies will deny claims that seem totally straightforward to us. We've had plumbing claims, particularly, where they had a leak in a bathroom, one of the valves failed. They had a plumber come out, and the plumber submitted a report that said it was wear and tear, and the insurance company just denied it on the spot. You don't have wear and tear on your valves and on your toilet in your bathroom. That doesn't make any sense. We went back through. I actually built a small apparatus, and we took the actual part out of their house, plugged it back in, put it on proper pressure, and showed that it was just faulty. It failed. It
Amazing.
Was leaking everywhere, and they paid the claim, but they had just denied it flat out. I don't think the adjuster had ever even been to the property.
That's really sad. And people get hurt all the time. It's really sad. That's why they're here on your side. .us.com. That is what they're here for. And to tell you that they can do second opinions as well, I think that it's really important, too, that people understand that right now, a lot's going on. We've got a lot of craziness going on in our world right now. You have maybe family members that are probably living with you all of a sudden because they might not be working right now. And you've got more going on in your house, and it could be that you get a disaster. This could happen. Some kind of, it could be a fire. It could be a flood. It could be the rain. We've got rains, and we've got so many things. We had a lot of rain the other day, and a lot of people might have had roof damage, and so give them a call. You can do it. It's your right to do it, right?
Absolutely. Absolutely.
What would be some of the final words that you might want to say? Or if you want to say something, Michael, you can chime in too.
I mean, what I would say is that if you've been paying for your insurance for all these years, you've met all of your obligations. And when something happens, it's the insurance company's time to meet their obligations.
Right.
And we can help make sure that that happens for you, that they are going to meet their obligations.
And Michael, go ahead.
Yeah, we're not expecting you to know your policy inside and out. That's a lot of reading in legal language that no one really wants to get part of, except us. We know your policy. We know how to read the policies. We know how to read the endorsements. And we will get you everything that policy is designed to do.
Give them a call, especially if you want a second opinion. What would be your final words, Carolyn? Do you want to say anything out there for people out there? It's a scary world out there. They deserve to be covered. They deserve to have someone like you come out. And when you have several people that work for you that come out and do this, and again, it's on a contingency basis. Go ahead.
Right. So if your claim's denied and you want us to take a look at it and see if we can turn it around, the time that we spent, there's no charge to you. It's not out of pocket. It's only if we get the claim approved that you would be paying us.
I think that people should just have the book. I know everybody should call in and have that too. And write this number down. You just never know when something can happen. You call your insurance company and tell them what's going on, but then make this phone call. It's very important that you do it. I only wish I had somebody that I knew this information. The number to call them, it's 480-840-1816. They do free consultations. They're nationwide. They're both residential and commercial. They do second opinions. Their website is onyourside.us.com. Final words. Michael, I'm going to let you do it because you got cut off a lot. Go ahead.
Thank you so much. Final word is always be prepared. Know that you have someone in your corner. Know your policy rights, and if you're not certain, ask questions. Give us a call.
Call in here and get this survivor's guide. I think everybody should have it. I have mine. Our number here, 602-277-5369. Toll free, it's 1-866-536-1100. What do you want to say? Either of you, what do you want to say?
On average, we recover between 2 and 4 times what you would have gotten from the insurance company on your own.
You guys, I'm telling you now, if it could happen to me, it's what?
What he said.
What did you want to say?
No, what he said. Exactly, yeah.
Exactly the same thing. She said, that's right. The number to call them direct, it's 480-840-1816. Across that line.